the 21st salesperson, if they are worth their salt, knows sales is about asking questions and listening. Hopefully, long gone is that pushy 20th century snake oil salesman. With that said, listening is an important key, but it's not the only key to build trust with the buyer. Here's an important way to build trust with the buyer and differentiate yourself from the competitor. Keep watching. Questions when you're on a sales appointment or making phone sales calls. Here are 7 unanticipated questions to ask the buyer. Question number 1, why do you think that? Refrain from asking questions that require just a simple yes or no answer. The idea when asking questions is to dive deeper, and let the buyer talk. When you ask open-ended questions, it allows the buyer to expand and you'll discover even more information. You can also say, can you elaborate, or tell me more. Always be curious. Number 2, what would be your perfect solution? Ask the buyer that. This question helps the buyer explore in more detail his problems and issues. You'll get more information on what they really need. Now, this will greatly help you to learn how to tailor your pitch at the end of your sales call. Question number 3, can I tell you about myself? I always ask permission before I delve into what I would like for them to learn about what I do. Now, yes, you're right. We've always been told that it's not about us, right? It's about the buyer. But it is important in order to form trust and rapport that they do know about you and your company. So be prepared to have a story about you and your company, not just regurgitating facts. People connect with stories, not facts. Number 4, if you were your competitor, what one thing would you do? Have the buyer sit in the shoes of his current competitors. This question is really good for B2B sales. It allows the buyer to think about their situation from different angles. Number 5, do you prefer I quit calling? Now, this question should only be used when you feel like you're not really getting anywhere with the buyer. Sometimes when you're direct, as in, do you prefer I quit calling, will actually cause and allow that buyer to be direct back to you, and you may find the smoking gun or another smoke screen. Then it's your call if you want to walk away. Number 6, what worries you the most about your problem? Or you can state the problem too. What worries you the most, Mr. Buyer, about not staying current and up to date in digital marketing? State some of the problems he said and ask him what worries him about not solving the problem. This will give you great insight. It will also help flush out other worries and concerns and possibly more problems that the buyer hasn't considered. Number 7, have I asked you everything you need for me to know? This is a question obviously you're going to ask at the end of the sales call. It also allows the buyer to think deeper. Has he told you everything you need to know to solve his problem? It also shows, as a professional, you are concerned about helping him solve his problem. It's just not always about you making the sale. This week, during your sales calls, integrate some of these questions into your sales process. See if the buyer answers you in a more detailed way. And if you will, come back and leave your comments below and tell me about it. I'd love to hear from you. Now, give me a thumbs up if you're willing to integrate these questions this week in your sales process. And if you haven't already subscribed to the Savvy Sales Lady channel, I want to invite you to hit that subscribe button and notification bell. We're a channel for all salespeople. But remember this, sales is a journey. It's not a quick trip around the block. See you on the next video.